traju hitovi za sva vremena.
Opusti se. Hello dear friends, Judgment Day plus 52. Judgment Day plus 52. Judgment Day plus 52. This is a special day. Đurđevdan. Proslaviću Đurđevdan. Đurđevdan, the last day of the measures aimed at the prevention of coronavirus. Actually, the last day of the state of emergencies in Serbia. So the state of emergency lasted for 52 days. 52 days, the state of emergency. I'm now trying to see. I'm trying to see. And I see. As I mentioned in one of my previous videos, Đurđevdan, or the Saint George's Day, is the, okay, it's the Slava Day of many Serbian families. I am congratulating the Slava, Srećna Slava, to all that celebrate. But also is the kind of a national holiday of all gypsy population in Serbia. Probably also wider, but for Serbia I know for sure. So now I'm trying to see, to find some traditional gypsy celebrations. I will be going to some places where that are traditionally populated by gypsies. But I can see some gypsies actually working now. I mean, this window washing, windscreen washing, kind of windscreen washing. Yeah, never mind. Let's go to Dušanovac possibly. And let's switch to sports mode because it's more fun that way. It's definitely more fun. Two BMWs in front of me. Ustanička Street. Only one BMW in front of me. Yeah, and the red light, traffic light. Ustanička Street. There is even a film, Ustanička Ulica. The same as there is a film about Bulevar Revolucije. With the exception that the Bulevar Revolucije, I've seen that film, and Ustanička I didn't. But never mind. Yeah, iz nekih starih razloga, prljavo kazalište, music at the back. Let me share with you some latest COVID-19 statistics. Well, actually not latest, but as of yesterday, to be honest. Three new deaths, so the total death toll being practically 200 exactly, and 120 newly discovered corona cases. So total being 700, almost 700. But actually, I also just learned the very latest COVID statistics from today, just from 1 hour ago. So additional three deaths. So the total death toll as of today is 203. 114 new cases. out of 6,196 testings. So this is now ridiculously low percentage. I mean, the ratio is ridiculously low. The total number of infected persons 9,791 exactly. The total number of cured patients 1,971. Yesterday 284 new cured patients, which is double the number, I mean more than double the number of newly infected. So definitely, I mean, it is going slightly but surely going it's going out. Nada, almost. Hence the relaxation of the state of emergency as of this evening. Actually, today will be the last day of the curfew. So in less than 2 hours from now, there will be the last curfew in Serbia. As a consequence of the coronavirus spreading. Now crossing Dušanovački most, which is not a real most, I mean bridge, but rather a viaduct. I mean quite an ugly construction, but it was quite needed. This part of time, so going directly into the area where, I mean, quite populated by gypsy population. Wondering whether I will be seeing some traditional gypsy celebrations. Not sure I will be able to see it, but let's see. Because the weather is also not as nice as one would expect for Đurđevdan. But let's see, I may be wrong, and hopefully I'm wrong. Let's go into one of the streets where I expect to find them. This one, I mean, one would usually never go into this street, because there is nothing here, but literally nothing. However, let's see whether we will be finding some of the celebrations, traditional gypsy style. Usually we will be having a chador or shators. I see some of the some gypsies, not this guy, but some other guys aside. But no celebrations. I'm now a bit puzzled. I'm quite puzzled. These narrow streets, a traditional mahala. Let's see, because no, nothing here. Nothing somehow. Now it will appear that I have been cheating you about these traditional gypsy celebrations, but really not. I mean, let's turn into one other street that this is not a street, but let's see what's this vehicle. decently close to each other. Like, let's say, as it is the case in Istanbul, for instance, in Turkey, in most of the cities, but also used to be the case in Thessaloniki, Greece, prior to the Great Fire of 1917. But after the fire, I mean, the city authorities have rearranged the city completely, I mean, the city center. There are some parts, I mean, some towns in Bosnia, for instance, that are really, really typical for this architectural solution. And it's not the style like as you can see in Dubrovnik or in other Venetian towns, where there is also very, I mean, the density of houses is such that the streets are sometimes only 1 meter wide or meter and a half or 2 meters. So you can practically jump from one window to another. This is not that style. I mean, I'm talking about slightly different style, actually, of housing. Much uglier, I would say. I mean, let's say much less appealing to a human eye. No, definitely there is no such thing as gypsy celebrations for this Djurdjevdan. It is a rather atypical Djurdjevdan, I would have to say, because otherwise we will be going to visit some friends that are celebrating this Slava Day, but because of this situation with COVID, everything is now more or less upside down. Never mind, let's drive the streets of Belgrade, in this case Voždovac a bit, and then we'll see what we'll do. So, just to sum up, Djurdjevdan in Serbia during the at the time of Corona or COVID. Yeah. Definitely a big destruction to the normal life during Djurdjevdan. Konobarice, Goce Tržan, nice song. A rather controversial singer. But yeah, some nice songs definitely. Yeah, I'm trying, actually, I'm looking around, trying to see whether I'll be seeing some typical gypsy celebration of Djurdjevdan. But nada, definitely nada. Okay, it is what it is. Barice. I'll make one more. There won't be such a thing this year. This year, nada. Never mind, Saint George. Saint George is killing the beast. Our in Serbian Sveti George ubiva zlahu. So as of tomorrow, there will be public transportation will restart in Belgrade. However, only for the employees. So if you are not an employee, won't be able to. it means you have succeeded, I mean, in your life. In other words, you are probably spending most of the time in some warm areas, and you have your own, I mean, probably you have your own cottage or house somewhere in the tropical areas. Not necessarily tropical, but somewhere in the warm areas. For instance, for Europeans, this could be South Italy, Sicily, Sardinia.
Naxi Radio.
Spain, Greece, the islands, I mean the Greek islands, not so much Turkey, I would say, but it can also be theoretically Egypt, and then of course some of the islands in the coastal region of Spain and Portugal. Okay, I would say that much for, I mean, this theory, as I said, it's a valid one, according to my opinion. So I'm, ever since I've heard it, actually even before, I had a tendency of obeying by this theory. What does it mean exactly? I'll tell you on some other occasion. And bye for now.